I mean, doesn't research show that laughter produces good hormones, mm-hmm. lowers our blood pressure, mm-hmm. calms us down?
Mm-hmm. We're actually in, it's February, so people are concentrated on affairs of the heart, and so are we. And I also lead a laughter club once a week, so that's another free event for people to come to. And that allows people to just relax and feel good. And they physically get the experience as opposed to the 20 minutes on the phone. So
I was thinking you should become a comic, but you already are one.
You know, it's just this develops your humor being. Mm-hmm. And when you laugh, the more you laugh, the more you're ready to reach for the joy button, I'd say, or your reactivity to things, it just goes up. That goes down and your ability to cope is so much easier.
All right, and why is it called laughter yoga?
Well, yoga, the idea is yoga is a Sanskrit word for union, and so it's just the bringing together, the idea of bringing together laughter and the pranayamic deep breathing of yoga. And so when we bring them together and we do these different exercises, they oxygenate the body. And we like to say it becomes contagious, definitely. But I found, because we used to say it would be contagious through eye contact and our playful-like nature, because we become playful. Sometimes it's kid-like, but it's not silly. It's just playful. And if we let ourselves play a little bit more, we de-stress a lot more, too.
And how long ago did you start with your laughter yoga?
what was it? February of 2008. Mm-hmm. And I just thought it was a natural connection to the coaching, so I saw this laughter yoga and said, I must do this.
And what has been the reaction of your family and friends?
They are laughing with me, and generally I was able to get my neighbors together the first year, and we got into the Memorial Day parade with a big laughter float, and we had a good time.
Was this in Park Ridge?
That's in Park Ridge. They do a great big Memorial Day parade. So we had and why we could be in the Memorial Day parade, because the mission is world peace through laughter. So mm-hmm. it fit.
Well, it's hard to be violent or hurtful is when you're laughing.
Exactly.
And especially if you're sharing laughter with someone, you know, you're not going to want to hurt that person.
You can't be mad and glad at the same time. You're one or the other, and it's more preferable to find the glad.
Yeah. So how did laughter yoga start, and who started it?
1995, there was a wonderful doctor, medical doctor in India, in what was then Bombay, it's now Mumbai. And he was writing an article based on the Norman Cousins experience of Anatomy of an Illness he was written.
I read Anatomy of an Illness
right.
back in the 80s, but why don't you explain Dr. Cousins? Oh, actually, Dr. Norman.
Kataria.
Norman Cousins wasn't a doctor, but he actually ended up teaching at UCLA Medical School.
Right.
So why don't you tell our audience who may not be familiar with
Norman Cousins is he was a journalist, and he developed this disease. It was called ankylosing spondylitis, and it was kind of a rheumatic disease. And he was diagnosed as terminal, and so he decided he did not want to live that way, and so he started laughing. He watched comedies, he had people over that made him laugh, feel good. And what he found was one of the things he found was that he could laugh for 10 minutes and it would cause a pain-free environment for him for at least 2 hours.
Yeah, he checked himself out of the hospital and stayed at the hotel across the street from the hospital. He said the hospital wasn't a good place for him to get well.
Right. And he went on to recover from that particular illness and went on to live a pretty productive life. But Dr. Kataria, the medical doctor who did start this program, was inspired by Norman Cousins. And so he was writing an article called Laughter is the Best Medicine. And he said, well, why couldn't I have a laughter club? You know, where people get together, they come out, and they get together, and they just laugh. So they started it out with jokes, and they found that jokes become very humor-related and very subjective. Somebody has to be the butt of the joke. And so he thought, why don't we eliminate the jokes and because it wasn't working very well. And his wife was a yoga teacher, so they brought in some of the yogic, the asana poses, and they realized that worked well to really oxygenate the body.